What's going on, Shrew Game? My name is Camden. I'm having a great day. In today's video, I'll be doing an update on BlackBerry, ticker symbol BB. We're looking at the wider view of things. I'll bring it into the intraday viewpoint as well. And then we're going to bring that flow of the calls and puts. We're also going to bring the Ortex data as well towards the end of the video. So if you want to stay tuned for that, just keep those eyes peeled. We're going to get behind the scenes into what these slimy, oh, grimy short sellers are doing in BlackBerry's float. So without any further ado, let's just go ahead and get right on into it. As of right now, I need to show you something crazy. So we're in a medium-term falling wedge, kind of this like long-term falling wedge, if you will. Bring this into the 10-minute viewpoint, or maybe the 15-minute. It just depends what you like. But as of right now, if we just go ahead and hit high point to high point, and low point to low point, you can see the technical setup we're in. It's absolutely beautiful. If you like falling wedges, if you know what a falling wedge is and know what it portrays, if I can break it down for you in simple English, it's just a descending resistance, a descending support, bullish consolidation to seek the support you desire in order to get the breakout ahead. As of right now, we're not only in a short term, we're also in more or less a medium term as of right now, and a longer term. So what was a double breakout scenario is now a triple breakout scenario. When it comes down to our max pain being $9, with us closing near 880, it is pretty crappy with us being 20 cents under where we were supposed to close, or a lot of us expected to close, if you will. And it's also extremely crappy to see the put call ratio being 75 to 25%. In between that discrepancy between calls and puts, and still have a close near the bearish side. I mean, just think about it. Put yourself in the big boy shoes, right? Let's say I did have enough money, theoretically, to sell a crap ton of calls, a crap ton of puts to people like you and me, people that buy the calls and puts, right? And let's say the highest bought up put options, the highest bought up call options, just the sentiment from retailers was the $9 puts and the $9.50 calls. If I'm that big boy with big money and I love playing BlackBerry back and forth, I'm gonna sell calls and I'm gonna sell puts around those strikes. And I'm gonna do everything I can as well to keep that order book in a stranglehold, just to keep it at a certain valuation at a certain amount of time. And it's been playing out almost every single week with us closing near our max pain. It's pretty obvious, right? It's just the people selling us the calls and selling us the puts, making money off of us. And as of right now, with this week closing under our max pain, you can see that it leaned more towards the bearish side, even though there was way more bets on the call options. So they're really trying to bring some bearish sentiment into the float of BlackBerry. I don't want to say they're doing a good job. In fact, they're doing absolute crap, because if I can bring your Ortex data over and just show you the estimated short interest percentage of the free float, this number right here, I'm just going to show you a few trends that we've had in the history of BlackBerry's float to show you how greedy BlackBerry shorts generally get. Show you how greedy the BB bears are. And I'm going to tell you right now, it is very greedy. You're going to be able to notice after this. So this was our December rip, December, November of 2020, if you will. Of course, the shorts made their money beforehand, but you saw this started to load up as the stock price was rising. It's what you're supposed to do as a short seller. You're supposed to average up, just like us long investors average down. With the stock price taking a huge spike up, some short sellers definitely got hurt, but they hit it up at this high point, the stock price ran down, and a lot of them covered. They did. They made their money in the float. It is what it is. It's what they should do as a bear. But shortly after, when the stock price fell a little bit harder, shorting started to pick up fast in a very rapid amount. They got the sentiment that they could drop this lower and swamp it lower, and they definitely did. A little bit of covering happened, and it's what you're supposed to do, right? Especially if you're deep in the red in a bearish position, a little bit more covering happened. But when this January rip hit, oh my gosh, it hurt a decent amount of short sellers, but it seemed like a lot of them averaged up, right? They averaged up, once again, as crappy and as scary as this could have been for them, they averaged up and they made money again on the rundown. The ones that got hurt generally covered at a loss or near break even, once again. As you can see with the straight shot up, like you had back here as well, it was happening as the stock price was falling. It blows my mind, but when the June rip hit, a lot of them got hurt. A lot of short sellers hit it up at the high point, and it was generally a mixed sentiment type of thing for the bears. A lot of panic, while some short sellers made money, but the rundown was hard and they just got out near the bottom of the bears trend. You would think that the sellers already having such a hard time in the float of BlackBerry would just kind of like start leaving it alone. They have not had any luck over the past few months or so in this float, so why would they do it again, right? You can see almost instantly, faster than this time recently, right? This was in July. You had a straight shot up in short interest. They made their money. They truly did. The stock price was falling, but instead of covering like the first amount of short sellers did, you can see the stock price took a run up from 950 to 12. Destroyed the short sellers, destroyed them. However, immediately after, the short interest percentage started to rise again as the stock price was falling, and run up recently from that 9.10 to 12.43 hit destroyed a lot of short sellers. You can see finally, for the first time in a while, the stock price is falling along with the short interest. Regardless though, they're starting to get greedy again. We're here the past few days that we've been talking about this short interest. It's starting to rise. And of course, it's not rising in a rapid amount yet, but just the fact that you were near 6.3% on December 3rd and you're at 7.2% now, the shorting is definitely starting to pick up. If I can throw you anything, right, throw a dog a bone, I'm gonna let you know right now, for the past 3 days, there's been more returning than borrowing. So it did pick up a little bit. The stock price has been hugging near the ranges of like 860 or so. And it seems like short sellers are getting a little bit greedy, right? They're getting a little bit greedy. I don't understand why they do this stuff. And one more thing, if I can show you as well, we had our exchange reported short interest come out today. So the exchange reported shares, it's not estimated, it's not self-reported, it's exchange reported. As of right now, we have nearly 36.5 million short shares in our float, but we have reported borrowed shares at 34.25. So there's a 2 million share discrepancy in that. And I'm not saying that Ortex is reporting naked shorts, but whatever's going on behind the scenes of BlackBerry, it's just something that it screams a lot of slimy and grimy things from the short sellers. I'm not going to get too deep into all of this to get all tinfoil hat on you, but the DOJ, the Department of Justice, has just unleashed a bombshell today. And it was about the U.S. Department of Justice launching an expansive probe into short selling. And these aren't just any short selling, right? They're going after hedge funds, just people that they think are correlating with each other and talks with each other and not really manipulating the market, but what I like to say, persuading the market to go in certain directions. And I love the fact that I'm seeing this stuff, because usually at the end of the day, when it comes to the SEC, you get fines on top of fines on top of fines. Come on. I mean, these guys get fined all the time. They do, 100%. If you go on the SEC's website, you'll see how much they fine people. But the Department of Justice, they're looking for handcuffs, man. They're looking to slap them on somebody's wrist. Now, this definitely does not exactly have to do with BlackBerry. It definitely doesn't have to do with any one stock in the market. But just the fact that this is a thing, it really could be some sort of signal to trigger more bullish sentiment into the stock market. We can all see it. I don't think anybody's lying to themselves, but it truly is an all-out virtual war in today's market between bulls and bears. You have just a bunch of selling pressure, not even from natural selling, right? Like, it's just a crap ton of selling pressure in the market while you're getting an insane amount of bullish volume, bullish sentiment, and insane amount of opportunities for valuable plays at low points. There is two sides of the story. The sellers, just the people that are trying to bank off a stock market crash, are putting their money where their mouth is, while the buyers are looking for the breakout. The buyers are looking for a stretch, an increase in valuation for the stock market, and they're both putting their money where their mouth is. It's really an absolute virtual war, and we're looking for strength. Honestly, we're looking for strength in the market. I don't want to sound naive or anything like that. In the history of stock market crashes, it's been extremely hard to point it out. So just think about it in a psychological manner. If everybody thinks the market's gonna crash, it might fall, it might have a decrease in valuation, but it does not mean it's going to crash. We can fall for a while, we can fall for a few months, it can be a rough, slow grind, it truly can. But if it sets value in the market and establishes that value, then people will see it, people will buy those dips, and it should give the market the strength it deserves. If we're not getting that strength as of right now up at these high points, then who knows what the world's gonna bring. But don't let people whisper in your ears what they feel, what they know, I mean, what they see. You have to do your own research, do your own DD to relate this to their viewpoints as well. Nobody really knows what's gonna happen. The whole entire market right now is just based off indecisiveness and confusion. So if you have your feet up and you're giving your trends time to play out, right now in today's market would be the best time to not really physically take notes, but just to kind of like mentally take notes if you have to. Realize that stuff like this, as crappy as it is, it can season you in the market, especially if you're learning from it. If you can like, share, subscribe, hit that bell as well. It'll help me out more than you can even imagine. Hey, it might help it as well too, dog. Get some more faces in the streams, the channel, just the videos on a day-to-day basis to see the massive growth potential behind BlackBerry at such a cheap price. If I love BlackBerry as a company and I think their stock is at a very low valuation and I'm a buyer, let's say at around 9, right? Theoretically, 2 months later, if we're still hugging 9, maybe even a little bit lower, I am still a buyer. In fact, it just gives me more time to kind of accumulate more shares into my position for a long-term play ahead. Hey, that's just me though. My feet are up, the Shrew Gang's feet are up. While a lot of people's hair is on fire in today's market, but if you're convicted, you know who you are. stay strong. You really are different than a lot of retailers in the market. Just being able to get through all of this movement, get through all of this slow grind, that's truly conviction at its finest. And if you're still here to this day, not only watching the videos, but just truly putting in time and effort to better your career, better your investment strategy, then that's all I'm here for. That's all I'm here for. I was in your shoes 2 years ago, and I had a rough time in the market. Just thinking back in my mindset back then, I can't believe I thought the way I thought. And I still thought I was the stock market king. So it's just the way the stock market is. It really has a ruthless way of giving investors learning experiences. So keep up with it, track it, and learn from it. And that's really what I can give you. We're going to continue to give these updated videos on a day-to-day basis, so just stay tuned for that. But I'm going to let you know one thing. Once we really start to kind of pick up our self-evaluation, right? Let's say if it does theoretically happen in a few weeks or so, I'm going to start making BlackBerry videos on a week-to-week basis. I know the BlackBerry Stock Reddit room would love that, right? So y'all stay safe out there. Have a great weekend. I'll catch y'all boys on Monday. Shrew Gang, I'll catch y'all boy as well. Peace out.
Shrew Gang.